How's it going? I'm Sydney from PhoneDog.com, and welcome to PhoneDog Live, our weekly vodcast. We're broadcasting live right now on Ustream, so thank you everyone for being here. We have a pretty good show planned, and you can also watch this on YouTube. So if you're watching the recording of this on YouTube, thank you also for watching, and you have the luxury of being able to use our timeline in the description. You can kind of jump around. But we do have some interesting stuff to talk about. Of course, Samsung versus Apple is big news. It's probably going to be big news every week, just as a heads up. It's probably something we're going to be talking about every week for a while, just because, you know, it's ongoing, and it's going to take a while to get everything sorted out. So we are going to talk about that. Some really kind of like wow moments, and so hopefully we'll get to that. I do want to start with some iPhone rumors. These are not, you know, extremely, you know, massively interesting rumors, but they are kind of like, all right, that's kind of interesting. And as we get closer, we're going to hear tons of more and more rumors. But the latest has to do with the battery and, again, the display. And the battery is kind of one of those things that we haven't really heard a whole lot about, which is kind of interesting considering, you know, everything that the new iPhone is supposed to have, a larger display, 4G LTE connectivity. I mean, so many new features. You would think naturally you're going to need a larger battery, and I guess, you know, everyone kind of assumed that it would have a larger battery, so we hadn't really heard that much about it. My shirt orange. I think it's kind of like a reddish orange, I guess you could say. It makes me look muscular. I don't know. I do have some pretty big guns. Check out those babies. Yeah. Anyway, okay. now we're hearing that the new iPhone battery could be a little bit larger. And honestly, it's actually kind of disappointing how little of an upgrade it actually is, if this is actually true. So currently, the iPhone 4S has a 1430 milliamp hour battery, which is, you know, pretty basic. It's got a smallish display. It's not LTE. It's HSPA Plus on AT&T, but, you know, not anything major. Multitasking, kind of limited. So 1430, it does a great job. You can get through, you know, 2 days if you manage everything right, or maybe longer. But you add a larger display to that. You add LTE, which is going to suck all the power out of it. You're going to need, like, a larger battery. But the rumor is saying that we should expect a 1440 milliamp hour battery, which is... The difference is pretty negligible. I mean, it's a little bit larger, but it's pretty much the same capacity battery. We actually have pictures of it, and you can see, and this kind of ties into the other rumor about the display, but it is actually a little bit taller, but, you know, still pretty much, you know, 1440 to 1430, and so... You know, I've talked about this before, you know, the new iPhone, things that it has to have. There's things that we've heard that it could have this or it could have that. Things that it has to have, in my opinion, would be a larger display and LTE. I know we have an HSPA Plus version, and hopefully, you know, I doubt it will come to T-Mobile, but, you know, maybe like an increased HSPA Plus speeds. But really, LTE. AT&T has an LTE network. Verizon has an LTE network. Sprint has an LTE network. It needs to be an LTE device, and it needs to have a larger display. And when you think about adding all of those things, you probably will need a larger battery. Now, like I said before, like currently with the iPhone, you can get through about 2 days, depending on your usage. So... You know, okay, if it's basically the same size and you throw on LTE and a larger display, you know, maybe it'll take it like to a day or day and a half, which is still good. You know, me personally, as long as I can make it through a full day, I'm fine because I can charge it every night anyway. So it's not that big of a deal. So, you know, maybe that's what Apple is thinking. Like, you know, we're sorry, we just can't make it any larger, but they'll be okay because as long as it gets them through a full day. I'm not sure. The only other alternative, and this is what... you know, kind of freaks me out a little bit, is that it might not actually be an LTE phone, because you would think that, you know, technology and how it kind of drains the battery a lot faster, you would think that they would kind of want to beef up the battery a little bit more than just, you know, 1430 to 1440. But, you know, they didn't, apparently. So does that mean that it's not going to be an LTE phone? I don't know. I think that would be incredibly ridiculous. But again, I think I've said before, I would not be surprised if it were an LTE device, obviously. But at the same time, I honestly wouldn't be surprised if it wasn't an LTE phone, just because that's what Apple does. They just, you know, they do stuff like that because for whatever reason, you know, maybe they don't think 4G technology is developed enough, you know, although I think it is, but, you know, maybe they don't feel that way. But anyway, we'll have to see if this rumor actually turns out to be true, but for the time being, it's disappointing because it either means, one, we're getting LTE with the same size battery, which is a little bit scary, or two, we're not getting LTE, and either way, neither one is really that good, and so it's kind of, you know, a little disappointing. Also, so next rumor, the display. So we've heard that it's going to have a larger display, and this is kind of one of those things that it's almost all but confirmed. I mean, everything else, you know, LTE, the battery, the design, you know, those things, like, it can kind of, like, go back and forth. But a larger display, we've heard so many rumors about it, and so many specifics, and so many sources, and so much, that it's pretty much almost all but confirmed. Hasn't been confirmed, obviously, yet, but, so here's one more, you know, rumor to pile on to everything else. 9to5Mac was, iOS 6 has been released to developers, and so 9to5Mac was using the iOS simulator, which is, you know, created by Apple for developers to use. And so they were using the iOS simulator, and they plugged in the resolution. They tweaked it to run at 1136 by 640. And the reason they use that resolution is because that's the number that we've heard most commonly. Like, if it were upgraded to a larger display, it would be, the resolution would be somewhere around 1136 to 640. So they plugged in that resolution, and whereas with iOS 5.1, it would kind of just, like, stretch everything out, you know, kind of like the iPad, just kind of stretch it out. With iOS 6 in this simulator, it actually kept everything, you know, relatively, you know, everything was the same size, basically, but it added an extra row of icons, which is kind of interesting. I mean, and that's one thing that we've heard, that if they were to make the display larger, that it would be that they would just add an extra row of icons, which kind of makes sense if you think about it, instead of just, like, having larger icons. So, again, not proof that, you know, this is the resolution or that it will have larger display, but it still means that the simulator knew what to do, meaning that somewhere along the line, it had been programmed to do that, or it had been used for that before, presumably by Apple, since they're the ones that created it. I mean, why else would it know what to do unless Apple told it what to do? You know, how else would it know to add an extra row of icons unless it was programmed to actually do that? So it's kind of just, like, interesting. It's like, oh, that's kind of, you know, I kind of wonder if that means anything. It may not mean anything. It may mean this is the resolution. Can we expect, say, a 4.1-inch display with a resolution of 1136 by 640? Is that what we're going to see on the next iPhone? Kind of interesting. I think that would be a pretty, you know, I think, you guys know my favorite display technology right now is AMOLED, Super AMOLED, Super AMOLED Plus, all that stuff. I love the color saturation. I know it's completely unrealistic. I know it's over the top, but I love that. Outside of that, Retina display on the iPhone, I think it's just one of the best looking displays out there. I mean, just bottom line, you pick it up and it's just like, whoa. It's too small, I think. It's way too tiny. But I love what Apple has done with that display. And so I think making it larger and, you know, adding more pixels, obviously, because you're making it bigger, I think it'd be pretty awesome. Will it make me want the iPhone? I don't know. There's a lot of things that I like about the iPhone. I love the hardware. I love the display. I love the camera. I pretty much love every single thing about the iPhone except for iOS. iOS just doesn't suit me. I don't know. And that kind of makes sense because everyone's different. You know, everyone likes something different. So, would it make me try the iPhone? I would probably be more inclined to try it just because it doesn't have a tiny display, and it might actually have LTE, and so I'd be like, oh, okay, that's usable in the normal world, not in Apple world. Anyway, that's the iPhone. So I wanna move on, and I wanna talk about the trial, Samsung versus Apple. And this has been an interesting trial so far. Last week we talked about it was just getting started. They had jury selection. They had a couple of they had the opening statements, testimonies. They had a couple of witness testimonies. You know, you heard about Samsung, how they released evidence that was denied by the courts, which was kind of a big deal. But this week, Apple kind of has the upper hand, or Apple got the upper hand this week. Apple has revealed in the trial a report from 2010, and it's like 130 or 132 pages. This report shows Samsung highlighting 126 different aspects of their Galaxy S. This was back in 2010, so it was the original Galaxy S. Highlighting aspects or features of the Galaxy S, and then comparing that to the iPhone and saying, okay, this is how iOS does it. This is, you know, this is why it's so awesome. This is how we do it. This is why it sucks. We need to do it like iOS. And it's so ridiculous. Like, I mean, I've gone back and forth on this whole trial, and, you know, I think in some ways, like, Samsung has a case, and I think in some ways Apple has a case, and my bottom line was like, well, it's a trial, and so we're going to find out, you know, the truth is going to come out. That's kind of the point of a trial. And this is kind of one of those moments where you're like, wow, okay, so this is a piece of the truth that we didn't know before, you know, and people could say all they wanted about how, you know, TouchWiz looks like iOS, and we could be like, well, like, whatever, it's a coincidence, or, you know, maybe they just happened to do that. I mean, people could say whatever, but now this is solid evidence of Samsung, you know, taking the Galaxy S3 and saying, you know, this is what iOS does, we need to do it like iOS. And here's a couple of examples. Apple presented the slides, and so here I'll go to the calendar. So this is one of the slides, and you can see it compares on the left side, the iPhone. It says, day of the week date displayed on the calendar icon is updated daily based on the current date. Galaxy S, day of the week date displayed on the calendar icon is fixed on December 7th. Direction for improvement. The date displayed on the calendar icon should match the current date of the phone. It was just like, okay, I mean, there's a difference between saying, oh, that's nice, we should try to do something like that, and then saying, you know what, let's just do that, get that feature on the Galaxy S stat. I mean, there's kind of a difference there. Also, I thought this one was really interesting. Let me see if I can find it. So this is another comparison that they made. Talking about the background of the icons. And of course, we all know that TouchWiz, the icons look similar to the icons on iOS. You can't deny that. But this takes it even further. So on the iPhone, it says, provides ease of use to users by applying background only when necessary and using icons that intuitively represent their functionality. So as you can see, most of the icons on iOS, it's the full icon, and only on some of them is there a colored background. And then comparing it to the Galaxy S, they said in many instances unrelated functions have similar background colors, failing to provide uniformity and often causing confusion as to even their functions. And so the directions for improvement, either change the colors of bordering rectangular frames according to a consistent pattern for a uniform feel, or remove the rectangular frame and use the icons only for a clean and uniform feel. So with the Galaxy S, some of the icons had backgrounds and some of them didn't. With iOS, most of them don't have backgrounds. And so Samsung said, take the backgrounds off the icons and we'll just have the picture. I mean, it's kind of like, okay, this is taking it a little bit. Sorry about that. That was my mistake. It was like, okay, this is taking it a little bit too far. But the one that really got me was, again, has to do with the icons. And it's actually talking about the reflection on the icons. This is crazy. Okay, so this is the slide that, you know, in this report that Samsung made. With the iPhone, it says light used for a three-dimensionality gives a luxurious feel. Curves are fluid to give a soft and comfortable feel. On the Galaxy S, menu icons lacking in three-dimensional effect using light, icon edge curvature not fluid. Directions for improvement. Insert effects of light for a softer, more luxurious icon implementation. Make the edge curve more smooth to erase the hard feel. It's just like, okay. I mean, it's one thing to kind of make them look similar. It's one thing to be like, okay, that's a good idea. We should try to not have backgrounds for whatever reason. But now they're just straight up copying. Okay, the iOS icons have light reflection. Let's do the same thing. I mean, it's just like, you know, Samsung, it was, maybe they had a case before. I mean, they might have actually had a chance to actually maybe win this thing, but it's just like, wow. I mean, I can't even believe that they, for one thing, created this report and then thought that it wouldn't come up and bite them in the butt, you know. But, and just to see it actually in court, you're like, okay. And it was like I said, it, you know, kind of one of those things, you're like, okay, well, the truth will come out. And this is kind of it. This is Apple's evidence of Samsung basically just straight up copying. Now the only thing that, and it goes on. Those I showed you guys like what, three or four. It goes on. There's the music controls on the unlock screen in iOS. The music controls are there. In Android, you know, you have to swipe down from the notification panel and then it's right there. Well, they said, okay, let's just have the music controls there like it is on the iPhone. And actually the wording of the sentence in a lot of these slides is make it like the iPhone. Do it, you know, whatever the design or the style is, do it blah 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 like the iPhone. I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous, and it's just like, oh my gosh, Samsung, I can't believe you are so idiotic to actually do this. It goes into the dialer, it goes into the web browser, maps, the animations, the transitions, the icon design. I mean, it's like, it's 132 pages of Samsung breaking down every single feature of iOS and TouchWiz and saying, we need to change this feature to make it look like the iPhone. That's exactly what they said in these slides. And it's just like, it's wow. It's completely, it's definitely a good day for Apple. I will say that. But yeah, it's kind of just, and it's like, you know, Samsung, you didn't have to, I mean, you can create whatever you want to create. And you know, they had a good point earlier when they brought out, you know, yeah, maybe after the iPhone, we started making all touchscreen devices, whereas before they had like buttons and all kinds of crap. And they said, well, the reason we did that is because consumers wanted all touchscreen devices. And so we gave consumers what they wanted. And I was like, you know what, that's a really good point. And they could have taken that and said, okay, consumers want all touchscreen devices. We will give you an all touchscreen device and we will design a user interface that's nice, that's refreshing, that looks good. You know, whatever, design their own user interface. They didn't have to copy iOS. I mean, yeah, iOS is popular and it looks good, but create your own icons, create your own sound effects or features or animations. Even, I mean, they went so far as to copy the reflection to make sure that their icons were rounded just like Apple's. And, you know, we've talked about this before, and I've said, you know, one of the things I said was, so maybe they just happened to do that because, well, maybe they just happened to do that. Maybe they like the way it look. You can never really be sure of what their motive was, because motive is everything, especially with a case like this. You know, maybe they just happen to look similar out of sheer coincidence, and that's, you know, it may sound far-fetched, but it's, you know, it's a liable reason. But motive is everything, and Apple is kind of revealing Samsung's motive. As Samsung straight up said, how can we make the Galaxy S look like the iPhone? Here's a 132-page document on how to do that. And it's just, it's like, you know, you kind of wonder how Samsung could actually recover from that. Apple also had some comparisons, like, between Samsung devices before the iPhone and then Samsung devices after the iPhone. This one is actually kind of funny because if you look at Samsung before, let's see, Samsung before iPhone, and they're all like, you know, these were decent devices. You know, the Blackjack, you know, it kind of had some problems. But, you know, these were kind of good, kind of like Palm Pilot feel. They had a nice large display. They're like decent devices. And then you have the iPhone. These were all like, you know, pre-2007. Then you have the iPhone. And then after the iPhone, we go to this, and they basically, and it's like whenever you see them all side by side, like you can make whatever argument you want, and I've done that, you know, time and time again, but when you see them side by side, you're like, okay, that's a little bit ridiculous. Now, you know, who's to say that, you know, maybe it's kind of a logical design for a smartphone, so maybe like another design just wouldn't make any sense, and that's, you know, Samsung's job to prove that. Apple actually did have some alternate designs. This was actually kind of interesting. They had some alternate designs for phones. You can see here, some of these are like, okay, you know, the Nokia, the Lumia 800, definitely a good example. That's a nice looking phone. The Sony Ericsson Xperia Arc S, definitely a great looking phone. But then you go to phones like the Pantech Crossover and the Casio G1 Commando. Like, yeah, they're different, but no one's going to want to buy a phone like that. I mean, the Casio G1 Commando, actually the Crossover as well, they're rugged phones, okay? So that's why they have the thick shell and the different design, because they're rugged and they're meant to look rugged. Like, people don't want rugged phones just all the time. I mean, only if they have that kind of lifestyle. So, like, on the one hand, you're like, okay, Apple, those are kind of good examples. But on the other hand, it's like, okay, no one's going to buy that phone. They also had alternate designs for icons, which I thought was kind of interesting. I don't really think that these are good examples, but, you know, maybe that's just me. You can see it has BlackBerry. You know, the BlackBerry example is good because these icons do look different. The Meizu M8, also good. You know, kind of a good example of that. The Nokia N9, you know, this is Mego. You know, I don't know if it's just me, but these, you could make a case for saying that these look like iOS icons. They are a lot more rounded. And so maybe Apple feels like that's enough to make them different, you know, but it's like, you know, who's to say that someone couldn't confuse those Mego icons for iOS icons and think that it's actually iOS? I mean, does Apple get to determine, you know, does every person from now on who makes a phone, do they have to go to Apple and say, are these icons okay? I mean, it's like, how far do you go with this? Yeah, they may look different, but you know, we can't get the okay, or I don't know, maybe we can get the okay every single time. Maybe that's the way the legal system works now. They also had alternate designs for tablets. Some of them were pretty ridiculous. There was one that had, like, it was, like, a tablet, and then it had these, like, handlebars around, let me see if it's this one. No, it's not that one. It's this one. See, like, that orange one, it has, like, these handlebars around. And it's like, okay, no one is going to buy that. I don't even think I've heard of or seen anybody with that tablet. So it's like, okay, Apple, you have some good examples, like, you know, the Nook, definitely a good example. But on the other hand, it's like, sometimes I take it a little bit too far. Definitely, it has, that document was a killer. I mean, that was just a killer. And I would love to see how Samsung is going to come back from that, because you know, obviously you can't be like, oh, okay, well, that's the case. Obviously they copied. You know, you got to go through the whole trial and give Samsung a chance, but it's going to be tough because that's pretty big. So anyway, the case went on. They had some more, why can I not remember that word? Testimonies. Every time I try to say it, I forget what it is. They had some more testimonies, and it's been interesting, but that, the document definitely is probably the worst or the best, depending on what side you're on. So I don't know, you know, we'll have to see how it plays out. But it's definitely been interesting so far. And if you want to look at this document, again, I talked about like four or five, it's 132 pages. And there's like how many, 126, there's 126 different aspects where Samsung said, okay, let's copy this and make it exactly like Apple. They didn't say copy, but they did say make it like the iPhone. Pretty much, that's basically what they're saying. Galaxy Note 2. We have some more updates on this. I think we talked about this last week, too. Galaxy Note 2, it's rumored to be coming or to be announced at the end of this month, but we don't know that for sure. But now we're hearing some more reports on the specs. So now we're hearing that it will have a 5.5-inch flexible AMOLED display, as well as a combo of unbreakable plane technology and plastic substrate. The biggest thing is it's a flexible thing, because it's like, whoa, I mean, is it going to be flexible? I was imagining, like, how they would do that, and what's their idea, and how they're going to implement this, and, like, all kinds of crap, but it's actually not as interesting as it sounds. I mean, obviously, flexible means that it is obviously flexible, but the way that they would use it is actually just to make the display a little bit curved, kind of like on the Nexus 7. You know how the display is a little bit curved? Probably just to make it like that, basically. Nothing really, like, outstanding, or you probably won't even notice it, honestly. Now, we have heard other reports saying that it will not be, that the Galaxy, that Samsung will not be using unbreakable plane technology. So, you know, we'll have to see if that one actually pans out. But so far, we're hearing a larger display and a quad-core processor, and those are the two things that I think are going to be the major improvements. Obviously, the resolution will probably, hopefully, be higher, add some pixels there if it is a larger display. The camera, I mean, I would kind of expect an improved camera, but I think the biggest things that we can probably definitely expect are the quad-core processor and the larger display, which makes sense, because it's like, that would be the only reason to create a second one. Like, if you're just gonna improve the camera or whatever, I mean, it's not really worthy of a new model. So if it's a new model, I think the larger display kind of makes sense. 5.5 inches, seems kind of big, but, you know, you went up to 5.3, so, like, what the heck? Why not go up to 5.5? I mean, it's already just spaciously audacious and, you know, it's, I don't know, to me, it's a little too, and large isn't even, like, the right word. It's kind of, it's gaudy. Like, I've used that word before to describe the Galaxy Note. It's just gaudy. It's so big that it's almost like, it's so unnecessarily large, to me, at least, that it's just, like, why? I mean, that's just ridiculous, but then again, it's also very helpful. I mean, I know a lot of people, Aaron used the Galaxy Note for a while, and he thought it was great for, you know, note-taking, typing, web browsing. You know, if you watch the video about the Galaxy Note 10.1, obviously that has a 10.1-inch display, but some of the things that they did on that with the S Pen and the added functionality, not just with the S Pen, but just added features that they added, it makes sense. You know, that was pretty cool. So if they can add those things to the Galaxy Note 2, that would actually be pretty cool. But, end of the month, August 29th, I guess, is a Samsung event. There's two Samsung events coming up, August 15th and August 29th. And we know at one, we're expecting to see the Galaxy Note 10.1, and at the other one, we're expecting to see the Galaxy Note 2. So one of those. It'll be one or the other. And then IFA. I say IFA. I don't know if that's how everyone else pronounces it. That's one of the disadvantages of working online, is that you just read everything. So I have no idea how to pronounce half of this crap. Anyway, IFA, IFA. It starts August 31st and then goes all the way through August 9th. So it's like a week and a half. So we should expect, I think Sony, we're expecting an announcement from Sony just before IFA starts on the 30th. And we're hearing that we could see the Sony Xperia tablet. Yes, the Sony Xperia tablet. And then in the middle of that is Nokia World, September 5th and 6th. And that's when we're hearing we could see some new Nokia Windows Phone 8 phones. Which I'm really excited about, because You know, you guys know I like Windows Phone. Speaking of Windows Phone, we're hearing that HTC could be planning to introduce some Windows Phone 8 hardware in the third week of September, which is just a couple weeks after Nokia World. We don't know anything about these Windows Phone 8 devices that Nokia could be announcing. We do kind of have an idea of the phones that HTC could be announcing, and they are pretty awesome. So there's two phones, the HTC Rio and the HTC Zenith. Both of them were rumored to be coming in the fourth quarter. Well, the Rio was rumored to be coming in October, which is probably the fourth quarter, depending on how HTC does its counting. And then the Zenith was just the fourth quarter. The Zenith is by far the best phone. 4.7-inch, 720p Super LCD 2 display, quad-core Qualcomm processor, an 8-megapixel camera, basically like the One X, but with Windows Phone. And you know, in the past, I've gotten really frustrated and upset with manufacturers just like really like taking Android phones and just kind of slapping Windows Phone on it and then releasing it, because it's not good enough. It hasn't been good enough in the past. It's not good enough now. It's not good enough. But you know, the Zenith is basically like the One X with Windows Phone. Some of the Samsung devices that we're hearing about is basically like a Galaxy S3 with Windows Phone. You know, those I actually don't mind so much, because they're taking their best phones and putting Windows Phone on it. Like, it was one thing whenever they were taking like their mid-range Android phones and putting Windows Phone on it, and then it like became the high-end Windows Phone device. Like, that wasn't good enough. But if you take, you know, your top echelon, top, you know, best of the best phone and put Windows Phone on it, I'm okay with that, because it's an awesome phone anyway. So like, I would love to have the Galaxy S3 with Windows Phone. That would actually be awesome. Or the One X with Windows Phone. That would be totally awesome. I'm probably more inclined to get a Nokia device with Windows Phone, but just because I love Nokia hardware. But anyway, so lots of Windows Phone 8 announcements expected. You know, we've got, just a recap, Nokia World, September 5th and 6th. We're expecting new HTC Windows Phone device or phones in by the end of September, and then I think the Samsung devices, we're also expecting those by the end of September. So could we hope for like a October, November, December time frame for the release? I don't know. I mentioned the Sony Xperia tablet. We're hearing that Sony could be announcing that at an event the day before IFA starts, which was August 30th, right? Is that what I said? Yeah, August 30th. The Sony Xperia tablet is pretty cool. I have some pictures here that you can see. Sony Xperia tablet. It will have a 9.4-inch 1280x800 display, an 8-megapixel camera, as well as a front-facing camera, a quad-core Tegra 3 processor, and Android 4.0. And you can see it's got that curved side there, but kind of like the Tablet S. Was it the Tablet S or the Tablet P that had the... It was supposed to feel like a newspaper or a book folded over, and so it was like your whole... Which I think is dumb, but so you can see it's got that same design, but just not as pronounced. So that is rumored to be coming at the end of August, or the announcement coming at the end of August as well. Here's the rumored prices. 16 gigabyte model for $399, 32 gigabyte model for $499. Every time I say gigabyte, I like develop a stutter for some reason. I don't know why. And a 64 gigabyte model for $599. So starting at $399 with 16 gigs, that's not bad. That's actually a pretty decent price. And, you know, 1280x800, nothing really, like, super out of this world amazing. It's basically like what we see in every other Android tablet. But that's a good thing, because those tablets are good. You know, having a full HD display, a quad-core processor. So if you like Sony, or maybe you like that weird, awkward design, you know, then you may like that. Lastly, this is kind of interesting. Boost Mobile, Virgin Mobile, and Samsung are all coming together for an event on August 22nd. And this is a little weird because, like, it's one thing for, you know, a manufacturer and a carrier to have an event because, you know, the phone's going to be released on that carrier. But to have, like, two carriers with the manufacturer, like, it's unique. Like, we don't really see that very often. Of course, this isn't that weird because Boost Mobile and Virgin Mobile, actually, yeah, those are both Sprint, right? I know Boost Mobile is, see, there's Boost Mobile, Virgin Mobile, Metro PCS. Yeah, Virgin Mobile is Sprint, right? So it's not that weird because, you know, they're all Sprint. So to have them at the same event, it's not actually that strange. We don't really know what we're going to see. Obviously, it's probably going to be a phone, just a guess. They said that we should expect, actually, I have the invitation so you can see it. Let me see. Here we go. Says that we should expect some big mobile news. Something cool is sure to come out of this hot summer. So I was originally thinking, like, maybe the cool is like a play on words, or maybe that's supposed to be like a hint as to what we're gonna see. But, you know, when you finish this sentence, it's actually just a play on words to complete that sentence. I don't think it has anything to do with the phones themselves. So what could we see? I don't know. Virgin Mobile and Boost Mobile, they just added the HTC Evo Design 4G and the Evo V4G, which are some pretty awesome phones for a prepaid carrier, 4G technology. So, you know, possibly Samsung is like, you know, hey, we want to get some high-end devices on those carriers as well. So it's probably something like that. I don't think I would expect something. It's obviously going to be a good device. Like, you know, the Evo Design was a good device. The HTC Evo V was a good device. But, like, the Evo Design, like, you know, it's a year old. So you can kind of expect one of the awesome phones from a year ago. Like, basically, that's what it would be. I was thinking, you know, we might see something like maybe the Galaxy S, maybe, like, a lower tier version of the Galaxy S3. They do that a lot. Boost and Metro PCS, they have a lot of Galaxy devices. It's not the Galaxy S3, but it's, like, the Galaxy S whatever, and it's kind of just like a watered down version. So maybe something like that, where it's 4G, you know, Super AMOLED Plus display, you know, something high end, but, you know, on a prepaid carrier, which, you know, honestly, you know, it might not be the Galaxy S3, it might not be the Galaxy Note 2, but for a prepaid carrier, it's going to be a great option. I think that's pretty awesome. So mark your calendars for that, August 22nd. And that's pretty much the news. That's what it is. That's everything. So I guess we can move on to the open Q&A now. And let me see if there was anything else I wanted to talk about. I might be saving this for the dog pound. Yeah, I'll save that for the dog pound. All right, so open Q&A. Feel free to ask questions. And as far as I know, Facebook is still acting up for me. So, yeah. If you're on Facebook, it is not loading the chat window stream thing, so I cannot see your comments. So try to jump on Ustream if you can. I'm going to be starting school soon. Should I wait for the Note 2 or should I get the Galaxy S3? Well, you know, the Note 2, like I said, we're expecting it within, you know, a couple of weeks. So you could wait and then compare them both and see which one you like better. You know, that may be a good idea. Time to talk about high school again. No. Why did Sydney stop having those random moments on the dog pound? Yeah, the funny bits. Yeah, the comedy, it was fun. And I know you guys loved it. But I just, you know, I just ran out of material. And it was becoming, it was impossible. I had no more ideas anymore. You know, I would spend like 8 hours every Monday, and I would have enough for like a minute. It was not working. So I felt bad about it, but, you know. Tentative dates for the iPhone 5. We're hearing a September 12th announcement, and then it should be coming sometime in September, October. That's the rumor, though. How close are you with Aaron? Well, he's my boss, so I guess as close as you could be to your boss. And he lives in North Carolina, so as close as you could be to someone who lives on the other side of the country and is your boss. So, I bought Windows Phone. I expected it to be like Android. Well, that was a mistake. Is Aaron going to do coverage of IFA Berlin? I'm not sure. I don't know. Do you think HTC should be making the next Nexus phone? Sure. Yeah, they make great hardware. Hope the iPhone 5 will be better than the S3. Okay. Sydney, what state do you live in? I live in Texas. Are there any new good Sprint phones coming? Let me see. The LG Eclipse, we heard that could be coming in the fourth quarter. 4.6 inch HD display, 13 megapixel camera, quad core processor, 2 gigs of RAM, 16 gigs of storage, and LTE. I'm not a big LG fan, but that sounds like a good phone. Oh, the Motorola Photon Q, that's coming. 4.3 inch QHD display, dual core processor, QWERTY keyboard, 4G, Android 4.0, 8 megapixel camera. That's going to be an awesome phone. That's what we have so far. Yeah. Okay. I would like to see a Pantech Nexus phone, okay? Do you ever use that computer behind you? Yeah, that's a monitor, actually. A lot of people ask me about that. I don't know why this is like a foreign concept to everyone, but it's a monitor, so I use it. You know, when my computer is back there, I use it as a second monitor. What coffee shop do you go to? Starbucks, mostly. What do you think of the Lakers getting Dwight Howard? I think it's a decent trade. It's a good trade for the Lakers. It's a great trade for the Sixers. It's a decent trade for the... It's a great trade for the Nuggets. It's a decent trade for the Sixers. I don't think it's a great trade for the Magic. I'm not really sure why they decided to do that, unless they just got tired of him. Sydney, what kind of apps do you use on your Windows phone? Sorry, I'm kind of behind, guys, but I just wanted to make sure I got to... all these questions. Apps. So, yeah, my favorite apps right now. ESPN Score Center, Flixster, GDocs for, you know, Google Docs, obviously. Or, you know, Google Drive now. Pulse. I use Rowy for Twitter. Shop Savvy as a barcode scanner, even though Bing has it. I don't know. Slacker Radio, Weatherflow, for my live tile weather widget. You can see my weather widget right there. And then, yeah, those are the ones I use most often. Okay. Can we see your necklace, please? I guess so. It's just a thing. I don't know. It was like a dollar at Forever 21. I get most of my stuff at Forever 21. Sydney, are your ears pierced? They are. I don't really wear earrings for phone dog stuff just because, well, most of the earrings that I have are like dressy earrings. And I only wear them when I, you know, get dressed up. So, Oh, okay. Flixster is not available in Hungary. Sydney, do you wear dresses? I do. I have a couple of dresses. Mostly, like, when I get dressed up, I'll wear, like, a skirt and a blouse, because it's just more... I don't know, like, it's less expensive. Dresses are more expensive, obviously, because it's the full thing. But also, I like mixing and matching. It's a lot easier, so... have you played any of the Uncharted games for PS3? Yeah, I've played all three of them. I think I have the third one still. LG Viper or Motorola Photon? I'm gonna say the Photon. I've seen you wear earrings on Phone Dog. Yeah, I did one time. You need a cross. Okay. We know the Samsung Galaxy S2 Epic Touch is coming to Boost. Do you think there is a chance for the Samsung Note 1 becoming to either carrier? You know, it's possible. I'm not sure. What's your favorite store, like, ever? Probably Forever 21 or Best Buy. I'd probably say Best Buy. Does Slacker Radio use a lot of data? You know, honestly, I work at home, so I'm connected to a Wi-Fi hotspot, like, 80% of the time. So I'm not the person to ask about that. Do you play PC games? No. Are you a hipster? God, no. Do you beat your husband in basketball often? No, he's much better than I am. Do you like spam? Can you read us your whiteboard? Oh, that. That's actually, my husband and I joined a fantasy football league, and so I'm doing my scouting because he hired me as a GM. So I'm doing the scouting for the draft, and we're in a keeper league, and so those are... I don't know the keepers yet for all the other teams, but those are the projected keepers, like the people that I think they'll keep. So it's just like for me to know, like, you know, don't worry about scouting those players because they're pretty much already taken. That's what that is. Do you get Sprint LTE where you live? I'm supposed to, but I have a couple of Sprint LTE phones and I'm not getting an LTE connection. So what do you think is going to be the next leap in phones, keyboard phones to smartphones? The next leap in phones, I honestly don't know. You know, I'm just not that... I know I don't come up with stuff like that. I don't know. PS3 sucks. Are there any more Nokia Lumia updates? No. Have you seen the new Nexus concepts? Not recently, unless they were some a while ago that I just don't remember about. Will you and Aaron be going to WWDC? He'll probably go, probably not me. Can we have your PS3 username? I don't really use the live features a lot, so it'd be kind of pointless. She wore a dress when she was interviewing the Apple launch back in 2010. No, I was wearing slacks and a blouse for that. Not WWDC, I mean iPhone announcement. Oh yeah, Aaron might be there, I'm not sure. What's your opinion on Microsoft changing the name of Metro UI? I don't think it's a problem. I mean, I think it still looks the same. Did you watch The Dark Knight Rises? I did. It was pretty good. I want to make sure that I... Okay. What is fantasy football? you don't know what fantasy football is? Oh, it's like... So it's... You get, you know, your friends or whoever, people online, and they all have their own teams, but they're not like... You know, I'm not like the Ravens. You know, I have my own team with my own name. And anyway, and then when you do the draft, all of the current NFL players are part of the draft. And then you have, you know, your picks. It goes in order, and then you draft those players. And then, so you can have, you know, players from, like, you know, the Cowboys or the Packers or the Jets or whoever. And then every time that player plays a game, you know, you get points for certain stats. And then, you know, you go up, your team goes up against another team. It's like, it's, I think it's fun. What do you think of the Exynos 5 processor so far? Sounds impressive. Yeah, I was reading about it today. Better battery performance, which I think is, you know, one of the best things. But yeah, it was a lot of things that were a little bit over my head, but it sounded awesome. So, do you have an Xbox? No, I don't. I used to, but we got a PS3. I do not understand that question. Are you confident in the direction BlackBerry is going? Do you think BlackBerry 10 will stand a chance or just, Yeah, I think it stands a chance, but you know, that's me and I might be wrong, so we'll have to wait and see. I like what they're doing. They're being aggressive, they're being smart, and they're really trying to do something different. They're not just being like, okay, this is what everyone else is doing, so let's do that to make sure we sell phones. They're trying to still be BlackBerry, and I think that's good. Tell us about your high school life. How was it? Well, I was not popular. I had a lot of friends, but we were like, what's the best way to describe it? I don't want to say a loser because that's mean, but I wasn't that. I had a lot of friends, but I was not popular. I just wasn't. You never said if you like spam. I said I don't like spam. Sydney, you should interview Tim Cook. What phone has the best keyboard in your opinion? Best physical keyboard or just best virtual keyboard is Windows Phone, hands down. Best physical keyboard, that's a tough question. We haven't had any in a long time. I'm not really sure. Would you do a BlackBerry 10 challenge when they come out? Possibly. Yeah, I might consider that. Did you get A's in school? Yeah, A's, B's. In science, like chemistry and biology and physics, I'm pretty sure I got some C's. But on my report card, it always ended up being a B, which I never understood. Because I was like, I was so bad in chemistry and physics and biology. I mean, everyone is. It's so freaking complicated. And I would get like C's and all kinds of crap. And then somehow on my report card, it's like a B. And I'm like, okay, I have no idea where that came from, but all right. Do you like talking about computers? Sure, yeah. Would you cry if I broke your phone? Probably not. I have insurance on it, so. Will Windows Phone 8 start screen lose a list of apps? No. You still just, you got the live tiles or the tiles, and you slide over and you have your list of apps. Sydney, I just started high school and AP classes are hard, I know. I got almost 100% in honors chemistry. That's awesome. Were girls at your school who look very slutty like girls at my school? I don't know what that means. Have you used a new MacBook Retina? I have. I mean, I went to the Apple store and I checked it out and it was pretty awesome. I mean, it was, you know, MacBooks, if you never used a MacBook, like, in day-to-day, like, I know you can go to Best Buy and you can see them there, but you don't really get the full effect unless you actually use one every day. MacBooks, MacBook Pros, they have awesome displays. They really do. It's one of those features that, like, people don't talk about. They think it's just, like, you know, a $1,200 laptop, and they're like, oh, that's dumb. But, I mean, the hardware is great. The display is beautiful. Anyway, so, yes, I've seen the Retina display, and it's pretty awesome. It's pretty killer. But then I was like, but mine looks great too because it is such a great display. So anyway, do you play Minecraft? No. I don't know the answer to that question. What do you think HTC should do to make a comeback like they had in the days of the Evo? I'm not sure. I don't know. Do you have any idea when Aaron will do some more Boneyard phone dog election videos? I don't know. Yeah, I don't. You'd have to ask him. Do you currently have the Galaxy S3 as your daily phone? I don't, but I think I'm going to get one. I think Aaron is sending me one. I have a Windows PC, but should I buy a Mac laptop or Windows laptop? If you have the money for a MacBook Pro, then get one because, I mean, I've had so many computers and laptops, you know, Windows PCs, and they were all like, they're okay, but, you know, you don't realize all those issues. Like, you think, oh, it's not that bad. You know, people, all those problems they talk about, they don't know what they're talking about, or they're just Mac lovers. It's not really that big of a deal. You don't think it's that big of a deal because you deal with them on a daily basis and you get used to it. But you switch to Mac and you don't have to deal with those, you're like, wow, this is so much better. It just is. Talk about Phone Dog Taylor's voice input challenge. You can read about it if you want to. What time is it? It's 4:58 where I'm at. My hair is blue. That's awesome. What happened to that guy that used to do phone dog wheelie news? John Quatch, he's gone. HTC should stop making new phones every week and concentrate on quality. Okay. What happened to the pad phone? It's out. Yeah, it's out. It's officially released, I think. Just not in the US. If you didn't get hired at PhoneDog, where would you have applied next? Actually, when I got hired at PhoneDog, I already had a job. And I just happened to get this one. And then I quit my other job. So if I didn't get hired here, it was like no sweat because I already had one. And I didn't even really mean to apply. I just, you know, they told me about it. And I was like, I guess, you know, sure, I'll apply for that. That'd be awesome. So yeah, I probably wouldn't have applied anywhere because, you know, I already had a job. Is One Paw Bandit rigged? No. I've had a lot of people, you know, they claim that because they've never won, but there would be no point to that because we get those phones for free. So, like, why would we not give them away? I mean, it was just, there wouldn't be any point. You quit your job. Yeah. I was working as an office assistant at a law firm, which was a fine job, but it, you know, it's one of those jobs that you get because, you know, you have to be a responsible adult and you can't always have the job that you want. So that's why I got it. But then the job that I want came along and I was like, well, I'll get that. What was your first job? I was a graphics designer. Do you like smoothies? Yeah, all right. Everyone says a game's rigged if they don't win. Sydney, are you in a gang? No. I still doubt there will be an iPad mini this year. Okay. That's a nice job. Okay. What was your bachelor's degree? I do not have a bachelor's degree. Solid red. I don't know what that means. Okay, it is 5 o'clock, which means it's time to go. Thank you everyone for being here. I hope that you enjoyed it. Hopefully I answered enough questions. So yeah, I guess I'll see you guys next week. I felt like there was something else I needed to say, but there's not. So yeah, I will see you guys next week. Excuse me. 5 o'clock or 5 p.m. Eastern time, right? Yes, 5 p.m. Eastern time on Ustream or on YouTube. If you want to watch the recording of this, you can watch that whenever. But anyway, that's it for me. I will see you guys later. Bye.